Ken Reid, and this is Hockey Card History. This week, we are looking at confusing cards. Now, when you think confusing, you might think error cards. When I think confusing cards, I think cards that make me go, what? Why does the card look like that? Was that really necessary at all? Top 10 confusing cards from my collection were starting way back in 1972, the Summit Series. Of course, Canada wins in dramatic fashion. That epic photo after the Paul Henderson goal, Yvon Cormier hugging Paul Henderson. OPG decides to commemorate the moment with Team Canada cards that looked like this. That's Yvon Cormier. That is simply his head. No neck, just a floating head. All the guys on Team Canada, their cards look like this. I'm assuming because they wanted to airbrush any club uniform that was under it. But man, couldn't you at least give the guys a neck? So anyway, that's number 10. I was always a little confused by why the cards look like that. Number 9. Now, I didn't come across this card until, I was probably 14 years old or so. And this guy, man, he was just a symbol of cool throughout the 80s. He looked cool. He was Broadway. He was Ron Duguay. He had the flowing hair, and his rookie card looked like that. Ron Duguay with a crew cut. I was confused. This is Duguay's rookie card with the Rangers. He was coming off a 20-goal season. And the locks did not appear on a Ron Duguay card until 79-80. And luckily for us, they never went away. Number 8. Now, as cards took off in the early 90s and the junk wax era took over, card companies really started competing to get a little outside of the box, show some personality on the guys. Some would say these cards worked. Others would say they did not. I would say they would, but they were still confusing. Doug Gilmour. 92, 93, Upper Deck profiles. That's just Doug hanging out in his blue jeans, his motorcycle jacket, in front of his locker. Doug Gilmour epitomized cool. Still does, in my opinion. For the record, Doug still has this jacket. This set also showed Denny Savard with a horse racing calendar and Brett Hall with a set of golf clubs. Confused? Me too. All right. When you're talking confusing cards, you have to zero in on one set. We're going to hear a lot about this set. We're talking 73, 74 OPG. This is around the time card companies, well, OPG specifically, started flirting with action shots of players. Some worked, some didn't. This is Billy Harris, 73, 74. I'm confused because where is Billy Harris? I can't see Billy Harris. I don't know what Billy Harris looks like. In fact, you can hardly see his face at all. To make matters worse, that's Billy Harris's rookie card. So young fans did not know what Billy Harris looked like on his rookie card at all. Confused? Yes, we're going to go back to that set. 75-76, Robin Burns. This is his only hockey card. There he is, making an awesome save in the Kansas City net. Wait, that's not Robin Burns? Robin Burns is the player behind the goaltender with no logo on his shirt because it was airbrushed out. Oh, yes, that's Robin Burns. That's the only hockey card Robin Burns ever had, and probably most little kids thought he was a goalie. Confused? Absolutely. Let's go to number 5. In 1991, everyone wanted in on the hockey card boom, whether you had an NHL license or not. That included a company called Ultimate. They made the Ultimate Draft Pick set in 1991. So basically what they did was they gathered all the top picks from 91, put them on an ice surface, and clicked away. It produced this card of Kerry Toporowski. Yep. That's the back of Kerry Toporowski's head, or is it? To make this card even worse, and this story was in my book, Hockey Cards 2, Hockey Card Stories 2, I tracked Kerry down to talk about it. This isn't even Kerry Toporowski. So Kerry's back was on a hockey card, but it wasn't even his back. It was the back of, he believes, Brent Bilodeau, who put on his shirt and posed for this photo. On a positive, Kerry did get $1,500 for the hockey card shoot. Okay. We're moving on to number 4, and of course, we're going back to 73-74 OPG. Can you tell me who Jocelyn Gouvernement is on that card? It says he's a defenseman. If I look at the card, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 players on it, two of whom could be defense for the Vancouver Canucks. So it's kind of just pick, kids, whatever. You can figure out who Jocelyn is. Okay. Number 3, most confusing hockey card. This photo took place in Tampa Bay. This is before this guy became a superstar. He was backing up. He was young. Now, back in Tampa in those days, the backup goalie didn't sit on the player's bench. He sat kind of down by the Zamboni entrance. And this young goalie was sitting next to a photographer who was taking pictures that night. They got to chatting. Photographer said, hey, I got an idea. After the first period, he bought the guy a hot dog, wrote his name on the hot dog in mustard, and said, why don't you pose for a quick photo, Olaf Kolzig? Olaf Kolzig posed for a photo with a hockey card. Olaf Kolzig thought nothing of it. 1 year later, Olaf Kolzig was leaving a game, and a bunch of people started laughing and pointing at him, saying, that's the guy, that's the guy. Kolzig thought, what do you mean, that's the guy? That's the guy with a hot dog and a hockey card. To which Kolzig responded, what are you talking about? They showed him the card. And that is one famous hockey card, a confusing famous hockey card amongst us hockey card geeks. And to be honest, I never noticed that the mustard spelled Olaf until Kolzig pointed out to me once. So there you go. That's how confusing that hockey card was. Hot dog and a hockey card. Okay, number two. We're going back to 73-74. When you're a Hall of Famer, a future Hall of Famer, you deserve respect. You deserve a top-notch photo on a hockey card. I call this the Where's Waldo card because where is Dave Keon? 73-74, Dave Keon, where is he on this hockey card? This is a face-off. There's one, two, three Leafs. I think that's Norm Allman, Paul Henderson, and Dave Keon. If you're a diehard fan, you know that Keon is kind of in the middle of the three Leafs. If not, you wouldn't know where Keon is at all. Big disservice of this. You can't even take Keon's awesome hair and sideburns into consideration because he's so blatantly in the background. That is one confusing hockey card. Okay, number one. The most confusing hockey card of all time. A card that made us go, why? Why? Why is this pitcher on a hockey card? This man scored 608 goals in the National Hockey League. For my book, Hockey Card Stories 2, I got to interview a man who scored 608 goals in the National Hockey League. But I didn't ask him about one of those goals. I simply asked him, why was he feeding a rhinoceros on this 98-99 upper deck? This is Dino Cicerelli of the Florida Panthers feeding a rhinoceros on a hockey card. Confused? Yes. The answer as to why Dino Cicerelli was feeding a rhino instead of scoring a goal on one of his hockey cards. This photo was taken when he played for Tampa Bay. They took the guys to Busch Gardens. They figured we're going to do a little photo shoot. Maybe it'll end up in a calendar. Instead, shortly thereafter, Dino Cicerelli is traded to Florida. The hockey card maker airbrushes a Florida logo over his Tampa Bay logo on his golf shirt and decides Dino Cicerelli feeding a rhinoceros would make for a great hockey card instead of Dino Cicerelli scoring one of his, 602 goals to that point of the 608 he scored during his career. The most confusing hockey card of all time, Dino Cicerelli feeds a rhino. Hey, if you liked that video, make sure to hit the subscribe button and subscribe to Sportsnet's YouTube channel. What I like to do is, well, look at all the videos and wonder what's in the background. For example, did you know Colby Armstrong is in the background of this shot? It's true. Subscribe right now.